We have started about cDNA library. cDNA library was complementary DNA library. How single stranded RNA can be converted into double stranded DNA. Now that was about rDNA, or you can say single stranded DNA. When in biotechnology you want the genome or the complete set of an organism. It could be virus, bacteria, bacteriophage, animal, plant or human cell. What do? You go to a genomic library. Genomic library is nothing but collection of clones. It could be virus, bacteria, bacteriophage, anything of that sort. So basically, a gene library constitutes of two different libraries. One is the genomic library and another is the cDNA library. A library is nothing but a collection of DNA fragments of different species, and in that, cDNA library is used for RNA and genomic library is used for the collection of the complete set of an organism. Now, in order to make genomic libraries, there are certain steps which are required. First step that is required is to isolate a plasmid. Now, plasmid, which is extra chromosomal self-replicating small DNA molecule, can be obtained from E. coli or yeast. Plasmids examples are PUC19 and PBR322. So you have to obtain one, a plasmid of your choice, depending upon your gene of interest or the genome which you want to clone. The second step, once you decide over the plasmid or the vector, you remove that vector with the help of a restriction enzyme. Okay, now once you have removed that vector or the plasmid with the help of restriction enzyme, you put your genome or foreign DNA inside that plasmid and make it rDNA. That is nothing but recombinant DNA. Now this gene of interest along with that plasmid is introduced into E. coli or host organism. The replication time of E. coli is 10 to 20 minutes. Now when your E. coli will replicate, at the same time your gene of interest along with that plasmid will also replicate and make multiple copies of itself. So let us try and understand how genomic library is formed. Let's see the definition of genomic library. Genomic library, it is a collection of clones. Can be viruses, bacteria, animal or plants. Genomic library is used to obtain large chunks of DNA. The requirements to form genomic library would be plasmid, second one is desired gene or clone, and the third one is recombinant DNA, which is formed after you put the desired gene into plasmid. And the last step which is required is host cell, to put the desired gene along with plasmid into host cell. The host cell will replicate and copies would be made of your genome. let us see the steps involved in CDN. You need to take a plasmid, which is circular extra chromosomal. Remove that vector or the plasmid. Now this vector along with foreign DNA is attached together, okay? You get an rDNA, which is nothing but recombinant plasmid. Now this recombinant plasmid you put inside a host cell, which could be an E. coli. Now this host cell, when this host cell will replicate, it will produce number of copies of itself. Along with that, the plasmid will replicate and your gene of interest will also replicate, and you get cloning, number of clone copies. Thank you.